glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. One thing we've seen in the MAC championship game, great individual performances, whether it's Randy Moss hauling in three touchdown passes for Marshall in 97, Ben Roethlisberger throwing for more than four bills for Miami, Ohio in 2003. Big-time stars emerge in this game. We could see more of the same in the MAC title game. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
Championship takes place today. Should be a great one. And now it's time for the coin toss. And it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
The Red Hawks. Matthews has the ball teed up, and we're just about ready to get this one started. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 28-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. They'll bring him down around the 36-yard line. Made at the 47-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Quick throw out to the receiver, and he's tackled at the 40.
The defenders are really going to have to get their heads into this game. That was a big play, and on first down, no less.
They get nice yardage on that run. He's taken down at the 15.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Carries the ball for a nice gain.
That'll make it second and four.
From the 9-yard line, second down. The stop right around the 2-yard line. Second down and goal. Ball on the 2-yard line. Touchdown, Central Michigan.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
And he adds the extra point. A 9-play, 72-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Schmidt from the 6. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Tackle around the 41-yard line. Taken down right around the 44-yard line. The Redhawks always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play. Caught, and big hit there to stop him. Strike over the middle. He's tackled right around the 50. About a 5-yard pickup on the old play action pass. And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. It's away. Short punt. The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. Central Michigan is up by a touchdown. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Calhoun picks up a yard on the play.
If it's any consolation, he did pick up some positive yards, but I doubt that's enough to make him forget the hit that he just took.
They go to the run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss.
The object was to sell the pass and then sneak by the defensive line with the run. The problem here was that the quarterback didn't sell the pass very well.
From their own 27-yard line, third down. Going deep. Incomplete. Good time to bring the pressure.
Yeah, I like it, because even if you can't come up with a sack, just let the quarterback know you're coming and make him feel your presence. Sometimes that's just as effective as a sack.
Lane will be the return man. He's tackled at the 44-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. He scrambles. Brought down right around the 36-yard line. He's on the run. He gets to about the 24-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
No, he dropped it.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith into your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Fires out to his wideout, and down he goes at the 6. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and the quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
He
got the corner. Touchdown, Miami. And now he's up over 1,000 yards on the ground for the year.
I just continue to be amazed by this back's vision. There are not that many who are better at finding a hole and hitting it hard.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. He makes the PAT. Matthew gets set to kick this one away. He'll take it from the two. And down he goes at the 31. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. And now he's got room to run. He takes it right side for a good game. Their own 37-yard line. It's third down. Throws it in a hurry. They'll bring him down right around the 46-yard line. So at the end of one, we get a tie game at 7-7. Tied up as we head into quarter number two. Quick strike to the receiver. Tackle made around the 33-yard line. Passes to the back, incomplete.
Pretty good effort here by the quarterback of trying to squeeze that ball into a tight spot. I know it was incomplete, but he didn't have too many other options.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. Looks for his running back, incomplete. So they're going to go for it here. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. And they'll fail on fourth down. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Makes it out to about the 43. That makes it first and 10. Got a man. Watch out here. Some open field. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
We might see another run here as it's first and goal. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. He has some room. Touchdown, Miami.
executed. He looked totally in control on that keeper.
And he tacks on the extra point. A four-play, 67-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. The Redhawks, quarterback down there on the sideline. Kirk, you and I talked to him earlier this week, and he is really the main cog in this offense. Doesn't look like he's that much pain right now. They need him back on the field before this one's over. Gets out to about the 21. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Second and 10. Ball on the 21.
Mike 55, Mike 55.
And here's a quick throw.
You never know what will happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
That brings us third and 10.
And it's almost picked off.
That'll make it fourth and 10.
Wright awaits the snap. And he's taken down at the 50. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Miami of Ohio is up a score. There he goes. Makes it to the 34. The catch and look out, and they push him out at the 15-yard line. He's got an opening. The five, touchdown, Redhawks. PAT. It was a quick three-play, 49-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
And the big plays that they had running the football were the keys to that drive.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Clark fields at the goal line. Brought down at the 20-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. He might have a chance. There's a very impressive open field tackle. Throws complete. He's got space to work. And he's tackled right around the 38-yard line. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
He goes out of bounds at the 45. Gets it out to about the 47-yard line. gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. He's taken down around the 39-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Run and he's brought down. And they make the stop at the 22-yard line. Slings it, and he's level at the 23.
That'll bring up second and 11.
Central Michigan's going to take their first time out of the half. From the 23-yard line, it's second down. He's on the run, and they got it.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Well, they've converted one third down play on this drive, but now they're faced with a third and long.
Kirk, we saw this guy head to the locker room a little bit earlier. Good to see him back on the sideline, and it looks like he could be returning to the game.
Now he tries to buy some time. They'll make the sack. Fourth and long here after the sack. The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. Goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Redhawks right now are getting the play out of their quarterback that they expected, maybe even better than they expected. And now, as we get near halftime, there's going to have to be some adjustments made on the other side of the ball.
Well, the defense has got to be happy we're getting close to halftime so they can go back to the drawing board and try to figure out a way to slow down this quarterback. I think that more often than not, you look back at the first half, you think about, okay, let's eliminate this, this, and this, and let's maybe try a completely different way of trying to attack him. In my opinion, they've got to take some chances and be more aggressive in trying to put pressure on him.
What they've done so far hasn't worked. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. The Redhawks are going to call their second timeout. From their own 39-yard line, second down. Under heavy pressure.
Well, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack, and somehow he's able to throw the ball away.
Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. I guess he'll throw this one as far as he can and hope for a miracle. He goes downtown. Incomplete, almost picked off. As they head to the locker rooms, this one is far from over. 21-7. Miami of Ohio.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back for their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, trying to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if we've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Fielded at the 9. He's out to the 30. What a collision. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Davis gains around 6 yards on the run.
That'll make it second and 4.
Quickly to the tight end. Brought down at the 48-yard line.
That'll make it a third and 1.
He's at the 40. Tackle at the 38. He's under some heat, and he's taken down at the 34-yard line.
That's good for being 4 yards. That makes it second and 6.
Man, left, man, left. Pull down. Watch the mic.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's tackled right around the 28-yard line.
That'll bring up third and inches.
Some daylight. Gains his way to the 16-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 16-yard line, first down. There's a strike complete. He's down. And down he goes around the 13-yard line.
Well, these days you've got safeties playing up close to the line of scrimmage, almost like a fourth linebacker. The only way that you can keep them from cheating up is to take some chances downfield.
So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down. Quick throw. So close, but they fall short of the first down.
You got to throw the ball a little deeper next time. Don't take any chances of coming up short.
It's up, and they tack on 3 points. Miami of Ohio, ready to kick this one off.
Second
Clark fields it at the one. He's taken down at the 23-yard line. The Redhawks continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Out of bounds, around the 27-yard line. Gets it out to his receiver, and he can't hang on. It's third down and five to go. Ball on the 27. He steps out right around the 30. Lane, the return man. Lane fields at the 31. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. The offense gets set to take the field. Last time out, they stuck it between the uprights for three. Up the middle for a nice game.
Call the game 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Quick strike, and he drops it.
Number 10, the intended receiver on the play.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Nice run there. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Gain of five on the play. That brings him second and five.
Tight right, tight right. Four down, four down. Hey, Mike 52. Mike 52.
Makes it out to about the 30.
Gain of 16 on the play. First down.
Go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. From the 34-yard line, second down. They'll bring him down around the 37-yard line.
Boy, did you see how the defense just swarmed to the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
This is the eighth play of this drive.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Their last drive ended in a punch, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. That's three down and one to go. The Redhawks lead it by 17. in this very pivotal fourth quarter. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. Wright awaits the snap.
Man, I'm not sure if the players on the return team were all on the same page there.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Makes it out to about the 44-yard line. The option gets him a yard at best. Nice run up the middle.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it 3rd and 5.
He fights forward to around midfield. Calhoun is waiting for the snap. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. And he's tackled right around the 26-yard line. Decent pickup.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
He's taken down at the 40-yard line.
That makes it 1st and 10.
The stop at the 48.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
Tackle made at the 43-yard line. He's got another one brought down at the 36-yard line.
That'll bring up 2nd and 2.
Pocket holds, wants to go long, and does. Incomplete.
The defense always likes to see a pass broken up, but getting the turnover would have been really big.
Here's the 8th play of the series.
A little over a minute in the game. Has time.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
And this is what power football is all about, folks. Tight end grab, first down. Tackle at the 32. And he is drilled at the 22-yard line. From the 22-yard line, it's second down.
Let's bring it. Let's bring it.
Hey, check right, check right.
Wants to throw outside, and he's got it. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
This is the 13th play of this drive. Just gets rid of it. Second down, goal to go. Ball on the 4-yard line. Fires incomplete.
This is a well-designed play by the offensive coordinator. Everything really seemed to be working just fine, except for the quarterback. He's got to throw a better football.
And this is the 15th play of a very solid drive. Under a minute left. Here's the handoff, and he saves a touchdown. Central Michigan will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. Here we go from the 7. It's fourth down. Taken down just outside the goal line. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession. He's to the 10. Gets out to around the 22.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. And that should do it. Our final tally of this one, 24-7, Red Hawk. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
Miami started this season with one thing on their mind: playing here for this trophy. And now that they're the MAC champions, nothing feels better than reaching a goal you strive for all season long. Congratulations.
For Miami University, they continue an above average year, upping their record to 9-4. And for Central Michigan, they go to 7-6 on what has been an average season.